Hi, I am Alok. So I will discuss HTML in this video. So under the HTML, I will cover history, HTML syntax, semantic markup, and the structure of HTML. So coming to the first points, history of HTML. In 1960, the Defense Department of US, that is called ARPANET, they only used that time most of the protocol of HTML. But after that, 1991, officially first public specifications provided by the Tim Berners-Lee. And W3C, they only 1997, HTML's codifications is identified at W3C. Okay, so in 1991 first HTML published, then again the so many different versions available in there, then is HTML 2.0, 3.2, 4.01, like this. But XHTML 2.0, that was very popular from 2000 to 2009. Okay, so and after that 2012 onwards HTML 5 is available in the market. So one thing is very important, what is a markup? Markup, in the simplest way we can say, markup is a way to indicate the information about the content, and HTML is markup language. So in HTML, all of the information about the content that is implemented by a tags. And HTML does the same things but uses the textual tags. And any markup language, we can use the angular bracket also. That I will discuss later. And one more thing, what is the purpose of the W3C? So W3C is the main standard organization for the World Wide Web. So whenever you are uploading any web page in the live, so they will check the standardization of your page. That is the duty of the W3C. Okay, your page is already following the proper standards or not. So you want to check for any page, there again there are various standards is already available or not in your page, then open the web browsers, there you can write the W3C validators, and in there again you will get the place to write the URL of your web page. You write the web page and then click check, then we can see the all of the your standards validations is available in your page, otherwise any web page is there or not, that report will come there. So with the help of this site also we can check in any web page which standards they are following, which standards are missing, all of this information will get there. And one more thing, I already discussed in the earlier, XHTML 2.0, that was more popular before the HTML 5. What happened, one group was there, that is called the WTWG, Web Hypertext Application Technology Working Group. Okay, that is now within the W3C only. So that group is the developers of the Opera and the Mozilla, they only formed this group. So these groups, they did the lot of the again the work for the XHTML 2.0, and based upon that work only the latest next version HTML 5 is available in the market. Okay, they identify which tags and other tags, how to modify another issue regarding the browser also, that is again identified that group only. Now that group is again the within the W3C. Group name is the WTWG, Web Hypertext Application Technology Working Group, and group is the developed by the Opera and the Mozilla. Now in the 2009 onwards, HTML5 is already available, and that is again the adopted the work done by that group only. And they only gave the name the HTML5. So that's why the whatever we are using, that is the contribution of that group only, WTWG. There are the three main of the HTML5. First things, how the browser should deal with the invalid markup. And another things, provide an open non-proprietary programming framework using the JavaScript for creating the web applications, and whatever the backward compatibility with the existing web, that is again the HTML5. That is again the one of the aim of the HTML5. Generally in the HTML5, actually supported by the almost all of the browsers, but still you can see in this graph, in this charts, full HTML5 supported most of the part of the supported by the all of the browsers of the HTML5, but still in the few part of the HTML5 is still not supported by the few of the browsers. Okay. Elements and attributes, these are the two key points of any HTML documents. So whenever you are writing the HTML file, you should know the difference between the elements and attributes. HTML elements can contain text, other elements, or be empty. It is identified in the HTML document by the tags. So inside the tag, whatever if you are writing any text, that we can consider as an element. Take example, inside the tag, if you are writing P, so P is again one of the element here. Inside the P, P indicate for the paragraph. Like that one, inside the tag, if you are writing the B, B is again bold purpose. So that is also one of the elements. Inside the tag, if you are writing the H1, H2, H3, H4, whatever, that is also comes under as the elements. And along with the elements, you have to write the attributes. Keep one point in your mind, one direct you cannot write attributes. Attributes is always along with the elements. So attribute is a name which is equal to the value pair that provides more information about the HTML elements. And apart from this one, one more thing is very important. In HTML, whatever the attributes value, there again the double quote was mandatory. But in HTML5, that whatever attributes if you are writing, double quotes, that is optional. With the help of the HTML, what you can do, that is again very important things for any programming language. You should know with the help of that programming language, otherwise a scripting language, what you can do. Then only whenever you are developing the applications, then you can select the particular scripting language, otherwise to programming language to finish your again projects. So here again, HTMLs, you can insert the image in your web page using the img tag. You can create the link means here one page to another page linking, that we can do with the help of the anchor tag. You can create the list is again the different types of the list are there, ul, ol, and another is called list item tags. You can create the heading means bigger, smaller, another format, that one h1, h2, h6, up to the h6 is already available in the html5. And you can define the metadata with the meta tag. This again I'll discuss in the next videos. And like this one, so many much more things we can do with the help of the HTML. So whenever you are writing the elements and attributes in the HTML, you can see in this example here anchor tag A. First of all, you see angle bracket symbol is there, that is called tag. And there again anchor A, that is the element's name. And after that you are writing the href, that is called hyperlink, equal to double quote, and we are writing the attribute value. So href is again the attributes of the anchor tag, and that is the attributes value http://www.centralpark.com, whatever you are writing. Okay, and then after that again we are writing the content if required based upon the elements, and then the closing of the tag. So you can see here opening and the closing of the tag. A anchor tag here started, and again you can see here slash A, that is the closing tag. So HTML5 opening and the closing tag is the must. Okay, but the few elements that is called the empty elements. Take example for the br, that is called the break line. Now go for the next line. Here you can see br and the slash, both you can put inside the tag again, right? That is also the possible. So this is again the opening and the closing tag is together only for the br. But you can see in the anchor tag A up to here, A to up to the double quote closing before the Central Park here, that is the opening tag, and the closing tag is after the writing the content, slash A, that is the closing tag. I think somewhat your concept is clear regarding the elements and attributes. Another thing is the important point for the HTML elements. Here the nesting elements is again available here. Nesting element is the same concept. Inside the parent elements you can write the child element, inside the child again the sibling elements. That way only we can write. So here any element content with the child are said to be the descendants of the parent element. Likewise, any given child element may have a variety of the ancestors, right? That we can see in the examples again. So here you can see the hierarchy of the elements. Any contents which you want to display in the page, that is always after the body only you can write body. You see, so opening of the body and the last you can see closing of the body. Okay, inside this body again you can see here parents p tag is there. So again, and body is the parents and this p is the child. Clear? And in this child again you can write the text. This is the some text something. Then you can closing tag is just now I told, now opening and the closing tag is important. Then the closing of the p slash p. Okay, same way here again h1, inside the h1 title goes whatever the statement you can write. Click here, then inside the after that again you can go for the division. Inside the d again you can write the p, but you have to closing required for the divisions. Okay, so this way you can nest the elements. When you are opening the tag, so whatever the elements if you are writing the next one, that we have to close. Then again the whatever the you started the element, that we have to close. Okay, you can see in this example. So after opening the body, again closing the body, and everything we can write inside the body part only. So these are the things again whenever you are writing the programs, otherwise whenever you discuss about all of the codes, then your concept will be more clear. So you keep this point in your mind. Opening of the tag and the closing of the tag is very, very important. And whatever the elements you are writing, that should be within that one. Opening, inside the opening and the closing of the tag only. Like this one again, H1. H1 is again the heading elements is there. H1 means the size of the font size is the big. H2 is again the little bit less. Again H3 is again the little bit less is there. Okay, so suppose that you have a one statement, share your travels. Those travels you want to make little bit bold. So what happened, H1 is the one elements in up, and again closing of the H1 is there. Inside that one again you use the strong. Again inside the H1 only you use the strong. So you see here H1 starting tag and closing tag, middle of that one again you have to open and the close the strong. Open a strong tag, then again the close the strong elements. See, another this way you cannot write. What happened here, H1 you open and H1 here you close, and here a strong you are opening and closing. This is the wrong way, it will not work. This is called the incorrect nesting. So whatever you are opening and closing, before that one, whatever the elements you have to write, that have to write open and the close together. Clear? Another things, as per our discussion I told, we'll discuss about the semantic marker. So what is the meaning of the semantic marker? What does it mean? Over the past decade, a strong and the broad consensus has grown around the belief that HTML documents should only focus on the structure of the documents. Information about how the content should look when it is the display in the browser is best left to the CSS, that is called the cascading style sheet. Clear? HTML document should not describe how to visual present the content, but only describe its contents, structure, semantics or the meaning. Any HTML document should not describe how it to visual present content. It is only describing its content, structure, semantics or meaning. That is called the semantic markup. Now what is the meaning of the structures here for the HTML? A structure is a vital way of the communicating information in the paper and the electronic documents. All of the tags that we'll examine in this presentation are used to describe the basic structures information in a document, such as articles, headings, list, paragraph, links, images, navigations, footers and so on. So you have a different type of the elements, articles, headings, list, paragraph, like this one. So based upon these elements only, you have to write the contents, okay? Under the heading, only heading parts, under the image, image part, under the footers, footer parts, that again the things we have to write under the HTML, that is called the structures here. Next one is the semantic markup language. What are the advantages? This is again very important, might be for your examinations also. There are the four main advantages. First thing is the maintainability. So whenever you're writing the web application in the structured format using the semantic markup, easy to maintain, easy to update. Why I'm telling this once? Most of the applications, forget about the small pages, most of the application, web application, what is happening, always required update, okay? And if your structure is in, your format is in the structured format, easy to update your page, right? And this is the great deal of the presentation of the markup also. Another things for any web application, first again the target is there, your page is the loading fast or not. So if you are using the semantic markup, otherwise structure format, so your web application, web page is again the loading very fast. Okay. Another things, accessibility. Okay. So generally what is happening, sometimes if you are using the any web application, opening the page, not opening the page. Okay. So just now we discussed about the HTML5 and the semantic markup, what happened, most of the browser it is supporting. So in that way, accessing of your page is again the more easy compared than the any other way. And the third thing is very, very important. Lot of the web applications are there, and the what happened there again, search the page. So many search engines are there. Google is the one of the search engine. So in that search engine, your page is coming or not, that is very, very important. And for that purpose, semantic markup again, the providing the better instruction for the search engines. We already just now told the meta tag. So using the meta tag again, you can do the some part of the SEO search engine optimizations work you can do with the help of the meta tag. Some part, not I'm talking about the full part, but some part you can do. Now structure of the HTML. Whenever you are writing the HTML documents, how to write the HTML documents? So first things, always start the your HTML documents doc type HTML. This is again the syntax of the HTML5, doc type HTML that we have to write inside the bracket. Then another thing is called the title. For every page, title is again very, very important. So this title is again somewhat related with the search engine optimizations for the search engines software. So here again, you see title, then again title, a very small document. So opening the title tag, and again you have to close the title tag slash title again. So the where this information will come, so you see in this window, whenever you are opening the page, so here a very small documents, this contents in the top, again the this part is available. Okay, after that again whatever you are writing, that we can write. But title tag is very, very important for the SEO. And title tag, we can see here, it is displaying on the tab of the windows. So that is the one part. After the title here, coming to again, this is giving the complete picture of your HTML5. First, we have two first points. You see here, first document type HTML. Second point again HTML, but this HTML should be closed here in the last. You see, opening is here and closing is there, right? Then again, the head section, HEAD head. Head section, LANG equal to VN, that means language is English only. If you are not writing the LANG equal to VN, then without that also it will work. By default, they will consider your system language is the English only. So HEAD is again the element that again we have to close here. Inside the head only, we can write the meta tag, you can write the title, you can write the linking of the any CSS file, and you can write the any JavaScripting, either the JavaScripting include, you can write the that code itself here, otherwise you can link any file. So this all should be inside the opening of the head and the closing of the head. Keep this point in your mind always before writing any HTML file. right? So opening of the head and the closing of the head also is important. One more thing, whenever you are writing that this kind of the programs and you want to run in the local system, you can see if you are doing the any mistake in closing of the head also. Suppose that you are writing the opening of the head, but if you are not writing the closing of the head, still there is no impact for your output. You can see the output in your local system. But the same application whenever you want to run in the live, so whenever they will check the W3C standards, your browser in the live, that time will get an error. Okay, so don't compare my local system is running and there it is not running. So that's why I told always follow the standard format as per the W3C standards. So a W3C standards is telling opening the tag and closing the tag is the must. So in that way, opening the head, closing of the head, inside this one only we have to write the meta tag, title tag, link tag, linking of the any style sheet and the JavaScript part. And after that you can start the body, body. And inside the body, you can see again closing of the body, you can write whatever the elements you want to display, whatever the contents you want to display. So here again, just example is there, H1 main heading goes here. So this is the first way, first look, you should know the structure of the complete HTML documents. Okay. So whenever we write the program, that time again I will ask all of this information, we'll discuss again all of these informations during the writing our first program. Now what one of the things is there, what is the purpose of the doc type? Doc type short form is the doc type, it is called the document type definitions. So this is the one way you are just telling to the browser, my document type is the HTML, that's it, nothing else. Okay. And doc type HTML, this is again indicating the version of the HTML 5, but here it is not again the, this is you as a developer, you know, but as a browser only they know only, oh, this doc type is the HTML only. And HTML head and body, here one more thing is there, HTML 5 does not require the use of the HTML head and the body. However, in the XHTML they are required and most web authors continue to use them. One more thing, HTML 5 also the person is writing again the HTML head and body, but generally that not required. But what happened, most of the web developers, what they are doing, they have a still just they migrated from the XHTML to the HTML 5. Na? So XHTML already that concept was there. So due to that reason only, they are writing the HTML 5 also. So don't confuse, better you write also, there is nothing will happen. The HTML element is sometimes called the root elements and all the other element, it contains all the other elements in that documents. Okay, so this point only you keep in the mind, HTML 5 not required, but still the person is following the format of the XHTML also. So there is nothing impact, that also will work. There are the two part of any HTML elements. One section is called the head section and another is called the body section. So head section contains the descriptive elements and body section that contains what you want to display on the browsers. So this any of the body section I will discuss again the next part of our video. So under the head sections, first of all, what is the meaning of the descriptive elements? Descriptive elements we can consider again, you want to provide the some information for the search engine optimization for the search engine, again the platforms. So that again the few informations that we can include inside the meta elements. So under the meta elements, one of the most popular things is regarding the character encoding. So character encoding means UTF-8 is the most popular encoding technique is there. So that is again the, you can write meta charset equal to UTF-8, but that should be after the head section only. Like that one again the meta keyword is there. Keyword is again utilized for the SEO only. So that meta keyword, whatever the keyword you want to specify for your particular page, that again we can write after the head section. That is again comes under one kind of the descriptive elements of your page. Same for any web page, the designing pattern is very important, layout pattern is very important. So designing pattern and the layout pattern, that we can do with the help of the CSS style sheet. So that CSS style sheets, whatever the things we are writing, that we can link that we can link again with the HTML page under the head section, and you can see the tag here, number 6 only lining, link rel style sheet equal to href equal to cs/main.css. main.css is the CSS file again, that is the part of your one other module of your subjects again. So this also you keep in your mind, this again we can write after the head sections. Same way, if you want to apply, you want to utilize any external JavaScript file for the any again the purpose, so that also we can write under the head section only. So today we discuss only about the basic introduction of the HTML parts. So next video again we'll continue for the next part of this according as per your syllabus. Okay, so if you have any doubt, anything, you can drop the mail and I will try to provide my best solutions for you. Okay, thank you.